How to Trim and Prep Chicken Halves by your favorite uncle, Uncle Bird. Welcome to Uncle Bird's Barbecue, and today I'm going to show you how to prepare a chicken half. Now the first thing you got to do is take your whole chicken out the package. We want to make sure we put the knife on the back side of the chicken so that we don't damage anything. Once the packaging has been removed, you also want to make sure you remove any of the giblets. You can use these to make stock or fry, but in this case we're just going to discard them. Alright, now we need to get the chicken onto the cutting board, and in today's video we're going to use a pair of OXO Good Grip Poultry Shears to cut the chicken in half. Now that link will be in the description. I like to start down at the bottom part of the breast and work my way up. Now one thing you're going to find out is that if you don't use just the tip of the poultry shears to cut through the meat and skin part, they're gonna kind of get gummed up. But once it hits bone, the cutting process is actually a lot easier. So you just wanna make sure that you try to stay in the middle of the breastbone as best as you possibly can, and go ahead and make that last cut. We need to cut the wishbone right here. All right, so now that we've got that cut, we've got the chicken open, and I'm gonna cut off any of the pieces that are gonna catch a lot of hot air when it's on the smoker. First thing to go is the tail, and then we're going to trim off the excess fat and skin from the bottom of the leg quarter. That's going to allow us to work our finger in there and separate the skin from the meat to create a pocket for our seasoning. Go ahead and cut off any extra of the neck, anything that's sticking out, go ahead and remove that, because again, we don't want to catch heat when it's on the smoker. Go ahead and cut down the middle of the backbone. I don't cut down off the side. You want to cut down the middle of the backbone. And the reason why is that's going to keep the leg quarter and the breast attached to each other, so that when you're moving them around, you don't have to worry about the pieces falling apart on you once they start cooking. So the next thing I'm going to do is go ahead and separate the skin from the meat. The best place to do it is to run your finger down in the joint between the thigh and the drumstick. Now, once you are able to wiggle your finger right there into that joint, sometimes it'll tear, don't worry about it. But the key is to get your finger right there in that joint and start to separate the skin, and use a rolling motion to separate it and create a pocket for the seasoning. You want to do the same thing at the top, but you want to put your finger in there where the joint or the wing and the breast meet, create a pocket, but you want to be real careful that you do not pull the skin all the way off the breast, because as long as you don't pull the skin off, it'll stay attached even while it's cooking. Let's show you again. Go ahead and get your finger down there at the joint where the wing and the breast meet, create a pocket, being careful not to remove the skin completely from the breast. And then we want to go down here, and you'll see where this is the area we'll be able to drop seasonings in, so we'll be able to essentially season the entire breast and the leg quarter, and they'll still be protected by skin. Go ahead and use your finger to create another pocket at the bottom of the leg quarter for our seasoning. Now the next thing we're going to need to do is we're going to need to jacquard them. I jacquard each breast 3 times and each leg quarter 2x. Now the jacquard is going to do 2 things. It's going to, one, make the chicken more tender, and then it's also going to help it cook faster. And if you decide to brine the chicken, it'll also help make your brine more effective, because it's created small channels in the meat. Just use your knife to trim off any excess, and you're ready for the grill.